Greetings, my friends. This is Stan Huston from the Jesus Entrepreneur Experience. What It Takes Radio. A new venture begins today, and it will definitely include you. You will learn how you can be on the air, on the top, and you can make your mark in 2019 so you can have a great 2020 vision. I oftentimes call this the week of goals and guilt. Goals and guilt. And I'd like to free you up from some of that guilt. And I also want to challenge a number of you who may think a little bit differently, because I'm going to proclaim, and it's a provocation to many, God is not your customer. That's right, God is not your customer. And that's coming up on the Jesus Entrepreneur Experience. What It Takes Radio is taking off right now. And indeed, it is the first business day of 2019, and we are off, and we are going. Hey, yes, this is the week of goals and guilt. Now, let me tell you what I mean by that, and obviously, you'll discover exactly what I mean by that, because you have experienced it yourself. Oh my, with the New Year's resolution and the end of the year. I don't know how many notices I got from organizations telling me that they sure needed my money and that they had all these good and wonderful things that they were going to do, and they really needed some help. And it approached a little bit of guilt from time to time. So even though I admit that I put some notices out because we are a charity donation, I was kind of easy, though. I just simply suggested that we could really use your help for the end of the year and for the new year. But I tried to make sure that I just simply suggested that it might be a good thing and that I'd be grateful. Good and grateful. I tried to avoid the guilt. But let me tell you, what I avoided, others certainly picked up. And whether it was a good cause or not, I was made to feel a bit guilty if I didn't perhaps do that. And then everybody was guilting me by saying, what are your resolutions? Why, you're probably too fat, so you better lose some weight. So there were all kinds of suggestions out there about how I could be a better person if I would just do this, buy that, do this. And finally, when I did reach 2019-2020, because of what I had bought or committed to or had done, I wouldn't feel quite as guilty because I would be a better person. And so I needed to become better. That's right. You can do better, Stan. And a little bit of guilt there, too. Now, I know that's goal setting, and I am the guru of goal setting. That's what a 3% person is all about. Somebody who has some very, very powerful performance, relationship, achievement, I hope spiritual goals in mind. Only 3% of the population really do, and I do encourage that. But again, maybe some good goals, but don't guilt me. It's perhaps not your business to decide whether I need to be a better person or not. Let me see if I can discover that truth for myself. Here's a little motto. It's been my unique saying for a number of years, but here we go. A truth told is good, but seldom heard. A truth revealed has greater yield, but a truth discovered is best of all. And a truth imposed is no truth at all. Our goal is to help you discover the truth for yourself. Truth told is good. Truth revealed has greater yield. Truth discovered is best of all. And of course, for sure, a truth imposed is no truth at all, at least for the people who have it imposed on them. And you can figure that one out, I'm sure. So there we are. It is in terms of the start of the year, and I have a lot of good and graced intentions. I'm going to try and do a number of things. The idea of a fresh start is wonderful. I believe it's a God-given thing. I'm glad we have New Year's. We have throughout the year a variety of places and spaces and holidays and holy days where we can do just exactly what God would like us to do, is, as we said before, forgive ourselves, forgive others, forgive reality, and perhaps even forgive God, where we can forget and forgive and push forward again. We can get a fresh start. So this is a fresh start, and I hope to make good use of it. However, do you know how long most of the fresh starts last? Yeah, fresh starts usually end in February. You know it, absolutely. The gyms and training centers of the world are full up today and tonight. And they will be for maybe a week or two. But by the time February comes around, guess what? By the time Super Bowl Sunday comes around, by Valentine's Day, most of those fresh starts, those good intentions and resolutions have gone away. That is, unless perhaps there is some spiritual wisdom and spiritual insight and some spiritual strength and purpose behind what you're about. And you know what? Then it just might last a little bit longer. Just think about that. Let that sit on your head. We say the Christian entrepreneur, men and women who want to make a difference in the world, they seek God's special wisdom, insight, strength, and direction, so they can be more fully alive, so they can build a business, a career, a company that truly matters and makes a difference in the world. And perhaps not only the world, our world, and God's good glory. That's what we want to help you do. We want to help you through this year to understand that, you know, there are ways that you can do the good things that you believe God wants you and you want to do in terms of being in the marketplace somebody who makes a difference as an entrepreneur. However, I also want to just circle back and perhaps relieve some of the guilt and perhaps do a little bit of a provocation on some people, and certainly on some of my fellow people like me. Let's face it, I was also kind of inundated with all kinds of, because I subscribe to all kinds of blogs and posts and programs about people who do what I do. Christian men and women, many of them with outreaches and businesses and ministries in the marketplace. And they were in full wind-up, throw-em-hard mode this past week. Now, obviously, part of that was their pitch for more support and their pitch for more attention. And I understand that. I certainly do that. But here's what happened. I got the impression that God really is very disappointed in me. You know, if I were really serious about this, I would be giving more for God. I would be doing more for God. I would be taking my business and making it fully God's business. I would be using my business not to serve my customers, but to do God's good and glorious work in the marketplace, in the universe. And there were so many admonitions that, in effect, God was in the sales and marketing business, and he was telling me that I really needed to make some changes and please him more in my life and my business in 2019. Did you get some of those messages? I hope I wasn't guilty of too much of that, but I sure got a lot of them. And I'd simply like to say this. God is not your customer. No. You are not serving God as customer. That's not who he is. He is not there saying, please, please me. He's not singing the Beatles songs. He's not begging and pleading and pushing and shoving for you to be a better vendor so that he can be a more satisfied customer. That's not how he works. God is not in the I'm the customer business. I one time had to chastise a young pastor who, as he laid it on us, and I simply said, you know, Pastor, the God that I love and serve is not some Persian potentate sitting on some throne snarling down at me and saying, Stan, you better do better. Stan, you better be better. You better give more. You better do more. You better serve and please me more, because I've got some really high standards for you. God is not my customer. He is my Lord, and he is my Savior. And he's my fellow entrepreneur. But he's not my customer. And he's not yours either. You are in the business to serve your customer. To serve the people and the positions that God has called you to. And if he has called you to be a plumber, those people who need plumbing are your customers. And as I said before, that's vital work. Can you imagine what the world would be like without plumbers? So that's just the message I want to leave with you in kind of a short little podcast today. Yeah, God wants you to enjoy his pleasure forever. He wants you to join him in the mission. He wants you to join him in what the kingdom is all about. He'd like to be your partner, but he's not your customer. Now, this is going to upset more than a few people, but I don't intend to. It's simply my way of freeing myself up from a little guilt and perhaps freeing you up from a little guilt. And please just let it sit on your head for a while. If you are a Christian entrepreneur, if you're a Christian man or woman in the business world, think it through. Think what I said is true. You know, sometimes I laugh and say, what would Jesus do and what would Stan say? By the way, they're not the same. But take what I said and give it to yourself, to your family, your friends, and give it to God. And see what he has to say about how you should live, work, and do business in 2019. I would also like to audition, and I'm auditioning right now. I've served many business and entrepreneurs over the world as a business performance coach, and I believe God is calling me back to more intense work in that direction. And there are a variety of ways that I know I could help you and your business in many ways, and how I could help you be a more powerful Christian entrepreneur. And I would welcome the audition opportunity to demonstrate by helping you. So if you'd like me to help you, please reach out to Stan Houston at radioedge77@gmail.com. radioedge77@gmail.com. We can help you. And again, just a moment. One of the ways we're going to help you is What It Takes Radio is beginning today as part of the Christian Entrepreneur Network. And what we are doing is we are now in the business as a Christian, as an entrepreneur, as a radio broadcaster. We are going to help you get on the air. We can help you be broadcasters. Everybody is going to be hit with the choice of what are you going to do in the internet broadcast systems. You will need internet radio, internet video, internet performances. You will need to have a way of platforming your work on the internet and to broadcast it, not just post it. And we, and a whole variety of we's, are men and women of deep Christian faith and entrepreneurial business and radio and television experience who can help you do just that. And we will welcome the opportunity through our business broadcast experiences. I will have a number of radio programs this year besides the Jesus Entrepreneur Experience, and I will be helping a number of you start your own radio programs on the internet worldwide, connecting with people all over the world. We will be helping you and many others do that as a part of the work we do at the Christian Entrepreneur Network. TCENglobal.org. TCENglobal.org. That's where you can check us out. If you'd like to help us, here's my one little pitch, but no guilt. TCENglobal.org/contribute now. If we can be of help to you and you can be of help to us, we simply say we're grateful. No guilt, no goal setting, just grateful. All the best, and may goodness pursue you as God pursues you throughout the year. I'm Stan Houston for the Jesus Entrepreneur Experience, for What It Takes Radio. Until next time, which will be soon, bye for now.